Hello, this is Amethyst Notari, the RPG chick, here playing a short walking narrative adventure game by, I don't know how to pronounce this name, Tonguç? Tonguç? It's T-O-N-G-U and then C with the little squiggle under it. Tonguç Bodur. He's put out quite a few of these short little games, and you can find them on Steam. This one's for $4.99 on Steam, but I got a whole bunch of these games during a sale, so a lot of them I got for under a dollar. One of them I got for like 80 cents or something like that, so I'm like, yeah, okay, I'll give it a try. For 80 cents, sure. I don't know if this is the one, but this is one of the cheaper ones, and he's put out a few of them. This is one of the games that, well, pretty much his only game currently that doesn't have any kind of sequel or something. So I figured I'd just dive into this one. And, well, stuff. That went away. The audio I have here, hopefully, I think you can hear me fine. I'm sure there's going to be narration. Yeah, voice. So, effects, I might have to change this. Because I put everything up to epic. So let's see, and motion blur, I'm not a big fan, but maybe a tiny bit of it. It's interesting, you can actually change, you can actually go up to 3 with motion blur, 3.0. Pretty blurry when you move around, I guess. This I have not changed anything. Head bob I left on, I might change that, and unfortunately you can't rebind keys. Disappointing, I have to use WASD, but you know, it's not an action game, so we don't have to worry about having to find the A button quickly, that kind of thing. So you can move, you can jump, and you can interact with things. And this game, yeah, I forgot to say, this game came out in July of 2017, so it's actually a pretty new game. So I don't know what this is all about here. Play Earth? Maybe if you were playing, you know, on a planet in the Alpha Centauri system, you could, it would say Play Alpha Centauri? I don't know. There's chapters. So as usual, I'm playing completely blind. No idea anything. The moment you doubt whether you can fly, you cease forever to be able to do it. J.M. Barrie, Peter Pan.
By the Morrigan, where is this place?
That was kind of loud.
It's as though my mind has been clouded by 1,000 ravens and my feet traversed 1,000,000 mountains. My Draiochta, where are you?
Who?
And the demon? Is he no more? Oh, Seraph, what are you airing? That you have wielded your celestial rule to renew me with life and revive my spirit? Then let me go back in time, back to where our story truly began.
Can I go? Alright, let me just quickly wait. Okay. I was worried I couldn't change this. I was gonna put the voice down, actually. See how that goes. Oops. Apparently I am underwater. Oh, I can move. You can move with arrow keys. Okay. I'm not using my keyboard arrow keys, just so you know, guys. I have a device. A tactical board that I use. Oh. I feel like a frog jumping around in there. Pretty. Okay, maybe... I guess this says, less sensitive. You know, weird how you could change the sensitivity X and Y axis individually. So you can see there's the little bit of motion blur I have. It kind of makes it realistic. I don't like to really, I don't know, go overboard with motion blur. Let's try 25. You can actually type in values. Oh yeah. That's pretty cool. It seems like it never... Alright, let me... Really ridiculous turning it down to 10 like that. Actually, this... Alright. That's maybe a little too much. Bear with me, guys. Because I have to move my mouse... to do a full 180, I like to be able to... I can actually do a 360 and without repositioning my mouse. That's the ideal thing. So apparently I can go that way or this way? Oh, God. Yep. Sorry, guys. I am... Head bob is kind of ridiculous. We got head bob, I guess because I'm on an incline. Side to side head bob. Yeah, this is better. Screw that head bob. The hell with Bob and his head. Okay. Well, I don't know where I'm supposed to be going. I mean... Oh, I can't go that way. Alright. So these are flowers, right? Not... Okay.
My name is Nodens, and I'm the god of hunting on my isles.
Sorry. Wow!
One day, when I was traveling in the forest of Banager, I caught a glimpse of some nearby deer.
So I want to make it lower, I just don't want to make the, have the music overpowering. Interface. Oh, that's just the dinging sound, that's fine.
However, they were not the only beings that caught my attention. A white wolf was nearing our mutual prey when a few mortals entered my canvas.
This is why I don't usually do this, guys. Just so you know, I'd usually play through a little bit of the game, messing with the audio settings. He's a little hard to hear of the music, isn't he? Well, that's the music. Okay, this seems good so far. Until he talks again. That's a mighty big tree. Very pretty. So this is epic level. I seem to be doing okay. I only have a GTX 970, so... I figured I can't handle epic, but it seems to be, yeah. I am steady 60 frames here. Okay, I get the feeling I'm supposed to be more down here or something. The music started again. Can I get up there? That's what I wonder. Apparently not, at least from here anyway. Not from here. This stuff... Okay, this is the... Those are bushes moving. I thought that one way up there was... some kind of creature. Ooh, check out these flowers. You know what? I know the name of these, too. Is it lavender? I forget. Definitely seen those kind of flowers around. Can I climb that? I guess we're meant to be going that way? Not sure. I cannot climb that. Alright, so we'll go that way. This looks like a nice little spot to just, like, sit against the mountain or whatever the hell this is and, like, read a book or something. Until some creature comes along and eats you. More of those flowers. Where am I supposed to be going? I cannot climb this. Oh, I can. There's another good little nook, isn't it? Deer! Dish deer. Now it's called the hunting god, but I don't think you hunt things in this game. You heard that. Or she heard that. Hi. What? Here's your baby. Here's your baby. There's the big daddy. So, do I exist? Because they're completely oblivious to my presence. And even if I was a ghost, I would spook them. Okay, deer. Alright. Bye, deer. Another big tree over here. Wow. That's me and my tree. We're buddies. It's funny, though, how the music just stops and then randomly starts again, like in a minute or so.
I was swift to spawn a whirlwind of arrows and dismay the humans. Yet when I kneeled down beside the brute, it had already seen the unholy end of a poison arrow. With my healing powers, I made haste to aid my new companion, who in turn told me her name, Draiochta.
Who are we helping? Draiochta. I like the music, I just hope we get, like, more than this, as far as music. Ooh, we got, like, a church or something. A castle or something like that. I don't know what's up this way, so let's head towards the castle or village or whatever this is. This What's that down there? A tanning rack or something? Oh, it doesn't look like I can get in there. At least not from here. Bastards. Poor Foxy Woxy! God damn you people, what are you doing to Foxy Woxy? I'll get you, I will. Yeah, I can't get up in there, can I? The barrier to mankind will not be traversed. You shall not pass. Let's see if we can go up this. Nope. We can go up some inclines. Oh, right, I can jump, can I? I forgot about that. Can I? Wait. I forgot I can interact as well. Can I interact? No. It would probably be pretty obvious when we interact with something. Those wizards put up that damn force field. I guess I'll go this way.
I knew instantly that she was of an otherworldly nature by dint of her uncommon color. She told me that she could with me partake in the creation of visions, allowing me a peek into my destiny, and perhaps later, the end of my eternity. Hmm. For many full moons she was my lucky charm, and I was her distinguished overseer. The souls of the woods flocked around her as if she was Abnoba herself. It was only later on that I learned that she not only attracted other animals, but also beasts.
What's the difference between animals and beasts? And who's Abnoba? Am I going to come across something that's not an animal, but is a beast? Cool. It's a big mama tree with the baby trees. What? Bina was here. Bina was here. Okay, I cannot interact with that. Huh. Where the hell is Bina? I can climb this one. I wonder if that's like an achievement. I found Bina! Yay! Can't get hurt. No hit points in this game. Ouch. Butterflies. This guy made this all himself, apparently. Very talented. I can't get up there. So we did have a new musical theme. This one. It heard me. What's this? Oh. That is a rock. I thought it was gonna be a bunny or something. Bunny! Come on, you can do it. Ugh. Watch me get stuck under the world or something. Oh, no! No! Ah! I can't go over there, apparently. More big trees. Who was at these trees? There's no... I can't strafe for some reason. You know, it's funny. Oh. You know, they... That is unusual. Okay. WASD, of course, works. They have the... back and... forward... arrow keys will work, but A and... what would be A and D doesn't. These side arrow keys are not implemented. Which is strange, why would they implement one and half do it? Yeah. Go back? Back where I came from? We're back away from here. I'm gonna go this way. Oh. See? I was talking about the wizards. There's one of them. Oh, I can interact? Named after Brizal, the High King of the World, every inhabitant posh and pearled, faded civilization with towers and domes, two saints fed by otters settled in homes. Sea creatures as big as islands will make you cower and be silent. Every 7 years you wait until the promised land of High Brazil. Okay. Interesting. I'm glad I didn't turn around and go back. I would have found that. Plus you guys would have been bored. So these trees... gonna strafe around here. Some of them have messages. Okay. But these don't. They're not big enough. So who's this companion that we helped? Oh. That's a horse, man. Are you my companion? I don't remember the name.
Feeling blessed about our newly baptized kinship, I went out hunting with her some more. Yet I soon discovered how wary she grew of my efforts to annex meat from deer and other animals in the forest. In fact, she treasured no better luxury than to survey my peaceful landscape and the swans on the pond with meditative demeanor. Gathering carrots for the wild horses was also something she glorified in. In truth, it was obvious to me that the act of slaying was deemed time-worn as opposed to the deed of loving by her.
Okay. So what you think about that? Want to ride? I can't. Oh, look at that bridge. You sounded a lot closer. I'm like, I left him back there. Yeah, he's still back there. Let's see if there's anything written on this tree. Nope. Alright. See, I did see that bridge over there. Oh, looks like we end over here. I'm gonna head that way, toward that bridge. Just gonna check this tree. It does say something. What you looking for? I guess it makes sense the trees wouldn't have good grammar. What you looking for? I have no idea. I'm looking for this companion animal who feeds carrots to horses or some crap. I'm guessing it's an animal? Oh, see, I can get up there. No reason to, but... I did it! Okay. Cheep, cheep, cheep. Oh, there's another big tree. What am I looking for? What is that? Oh. These seem especially brilliant. Mia! My jumping proves rather ineffectual, I must say. Is there a way up there? Because it's a really big tree there. Wait. Apparently not. Alright. I'll say no. Can't get up to big tree. So what other animals are we going to come across? We found deer, a horse, butterflies, quite a drop. I thought I was going to end up going all the way up. I went up a little further than I thought I would be going.
Egad, now I recall.
Egad.
The soaring wall of Nanto Sulta, she of Winding River and Sun-Drenched Valley. I vividly remember how the free thinkers tried to turn her image into that of a Daruga Dua. Yet
what?
Were taken by my mother's Anu's elite horde of the Tuatha De Danann. Now, how many deer have I heeded so far?
I have no idea what you're talking about at this point. Something about the free thinkers and the deer and something... turns something into something named that I don't recognize. What's this stuff? Oh. Could this be some kind of puzzle?
Never.
Have I ever? Huh.
Never. Truly.
Oh. Well, that was an easy puzzle. I can't interact now. Never. I thought it was going to be an actual puzzle that would be, like, difficult in some way. Nothing on this one. You missed out on your opportunity. could have wrote who you be or something on it. So beyond the barrier is more forest.
The mortal of my lands, too, recognized Draiochta's clemency and noted how she exerted her prophecy to reveal when the weather was changing. If the sun performed the next day, she would be elated for her omen. If the skies ere long would open with the tears of my clan, she would hide in a hollow, and all the mortals considered that amusing. I, on the other hand, believed her to be a benediction regardless. But one day, as in all good tales, something happened.
Was this thing a groundhog or something? Talking about the weather and staying in the hole. Makes me think of a groundhog. I will meet the mystical groundhog of gloriousness. And when I do, I'll say, hey, what's up? I think we might be supposed to be going up here. Or up somewhere. There's another big tree. With more words. What's this one say? Have you found the genie? No. Was I supposed to find a genie before getting here? Definitely, unless the genie looks like a horse or some deer, then I would say no. Jeez. It's just woods that goes on and on. Can I climb up here, I wonder? Thinking not, but let's see. Nope. That's the lowest spot. Oh, wow. I never bothered looking at the sun. Holy crap. Holy lens flare, baby. Bloom effects. Yeah, I don't know where I'm supposed to be going. Then I will go this way.
I had only assembled all of the Earthlings for a celebratory cave bear hunt when we encountered the mountain dragon, League Napiste, in the forest. Wow. Legend had it, it was invulnerable. My wolf, however, snuck over to the sleeping giant to investigate.
Oh. That dragon?